I've found the Bitcoin of artificial intelligence, which potentially makes it the next trillion-dollar opportunity in crypto, meaning this coin can go 350x from here. I know that sounds crazy, but I spent over 100 hours researching, and today I'm going to share with you exactly why this is possible. All the way from the macro down to the micro, in order to paint you a full picture of what I think is the most exciting opportunity in crypto today. The project is called Bittensor, with its native token, TAO. Even VanEck, the famous Wall Street investment management firm that manages $90 billion, called Bittensor the Bitcoin for machine intelligence. And I'll be sharing with you the exact reasons why I think this coin is going to explode at the end of the video, so be sure to stick around. But before we get into all that, I think we can all agree AI is the most exciting technology as of late.
Say that 2023 was the year of AI would be the understatement of, well, the year.
The surge of interest in AI.
AI is going to change everything.
OpenAI's ChatGPT went viral AF and garnered 100 million users within 2 months, becoming the fastest adopted technology in human history. Chipmaker giant NVIDIA's stock price also went vertical, becoming the third most valuable company in the world. So is AI the most electrifying technology to bet on in 2024?
I'm all in.
As you can probably guess, the AI market is only going to get bigger. But let's take a look at some data to see if this hypothesis is true.
You know, I'm something of a scientist myself.
In 2022, the generative AI market alone was worth $40 billion, but is projected to grow at an insane compounded annual growth rate of 42%, reaching $1.3 trillion by 2032. The global AI market is projected to grow by 19%, reaching $2.5 trillion by 2032. The Big Ideas 2024 report from ARK Invest says that the adoption of neural networks should prove more momentous than the introduction of the internet and potentially create tens of trillions of dollars of value. And here's what OpenAI's CEO Sam Altman has to say.
I think compute is going to be the currency of the future. I think it will be maybe the most precious commodity in the world.
There's no denying that we're officially in the AI gold rush. Now, what if I told you Bittensor is the ultimate decentralized neural network that incentivizes people from all over the world to contribute their computational resources in order to build the best open source AI models? And what if I told you the project is still in its early days, akin to having the opportunity to buy Bitcoin for under $1,000? You'd be pretty excited, right?
Yes!
But to truly understand just how monumental it is, we need to first look at the problems surrounding the conventional centralized AI. The AI industry was once made up of academic researchers and startup enthusiasts, but has now come to be dominated by tech giants like Microsoft and Google, because they're the ones with the money to invest heavily in the insanely expensive AI research and development. This concentration of power comes with a few problems. To start, they may have an outsized influence on how AI is developed, shaping the AI landscape that best aligns with their business interests. Consider this, if every time you ask ChatGPT something, instead of giving you a neutral answer, it spits out a response that consistently sways you towards buying a product that benefits them. Would you be okay with that? Would you like to have an AI gatekeeper who prioritizes their margins over your own needs?
Would I like to? I would hate to!
Because making money is their primary motive, being ethical comes secondary, which runs the risk of biases, misinformation, privacy infringements, and restricts access. The competition is fierce among these companies, meaning their AI models are private and disconnected from each other. Therefore, any knowledge or breakthroughs they have will not be shared with each other. For them, finding success in AI is a winner-take-all, zero-sum game. How their AI is trained also remains a mystery because it's in a black box, meaning there is zero transparency and no data trail to look at.
There is an aspect of this which we call, all of us in the field, call it as a black box. You know, you don't fully understand. And you can't quite tell why it said this or why it got wrong. We have some ideas, and our ability to understand this gets better over time. But that's where the state of the art is.
Controversies surrounding these companies are already on full display in recent weeks. Last November, there was a major failure of corporate governance at OpenAI when its board of directors tried to fire its CEO because of a disagreement on its AI acceleration strategy. And that's not all for OpenAI. The New York Times sued the company last year for using copyrighted news articles without permission to train their AI. The company also recently announced Sora, a brand new text-to-video generator. But even its chief technology officer, Mira Murati, doesn't know how their AI is trained.
What data was used to train Sora?
We used publicly available data and licensed data.
So, videos on YouTube?
I'm actually not sure about that.
Seriously?
It doesn't matter whether she's lying or truly doesn't know. This is a major problem. On the other hand, Google's AI image generator, Gemini, went viral for showing biases because it portrayed Nazi soldiers from the Second World War as people of color. Google's chatbot also came under fire when its response took this position, saying, "It is not possible to say who definitively impacted society more, Elon tweeting memes or Hitler."
I heard that. I wish I didn't hear that, but I just heard that.
There are many more examples, but one thing is clear. Centralized AI is mired in problems, which begs the question, how do we ensure that AI development is accessible, democratic, competitive, and transparent? The answer lies in decentralization. And this is where blockchain technology comes in.
Oh, I know all about blockchain.
Blockchain and AI are highly complementary to each other, because when combined, data is optimized to a whole new level. AI's strength comes from data processing. And when combined with blockchain's security, transparency, and decentralization, we unlock numerous possibilities for innovation and societal impact. Blockchain's key characteristic is immutability, which means that once the information is recorded, it cannot be changed. This is especially valuable in the context of AI, where transparent and trackable data trails are essential for accountability and compliance. AI models train on large volumes of data, so maintaining the integrity of this data is essential to getting accurate results. AI developers can track the complete data lifecycle via the blockchain. This means saying goodbye to that AI black box problem mentioned earlier, which makes the AI system more credible and transparent. Blockchain technology, by its very nature, is decentralized, meaning that AI services developed on it are not governed by a single organization. So there wouldn't be the kind of catastrophic governance failure like what we saw with OpenAI. An AI blockchain protocol would thrive because of its token incentive structure, which drives people all over the world to train these AI models and validate their accuracy, thus preventing any single entity, like Google, from manipulating or showing biases in the results. A decentralized approach will foster better collaboration between AI developers, data providers, and end users to create a vibrant AI ecosystem that can drive up its value from network effects. Even the founder and CEO of Stability AI, Iman Mustaq, agrees, opting to step down to focus on decentralized AI.
You can't beat centralized AI with another centralized organization.
The only way that you can beat it to create the standard that represents humanity is decentralized intelligence. It's collective intelligence.
Stability AI is the billion-dollar company backed by Intel that's behind Stable Diffusion, a popular text-to-image generating AI software.
If one of the leading figures in the AI space is switching sides to go decentralized, what does that tell you?
This is the future.
But what makes Bittensor so revolutionary? Bittensor is a blockchain network that uses the TAO token to incentivize the production of the best AI machine learning models. Think of it like a decentralized AI marketplace, an entire ecosystem where a variety of AI services is available to anyone, and it's fully permissionless. In terms of Bittensor's architecture, you can think of it as that of a base network with many smaller subnetworks called subnets. Each of these subnets is like an individual AI startup that focuses on a specific AI use case. Famous centralized AI services like ChatGPT and Midjourney all have their decentralized versions available on Bittensor, where it's open source. For example, Subnet 1 is a text-prompting large language model similar to ChatGPT, known as the Fini Prompt Subnetwork. Subnet 5 is the text-to-image generation model, akin to Midjourney. But it's not just about decentralizing existing popular AI services. There is crazy innovation happening at lightning speed, where businesses are being built on the network that generate real revenue, driving value to the TAO token. For example, Subnet 8, known as the proprietary trading network by Taoshi, is a network where AI is leveraged to provide the strongest trading signals on Bitcoin and various financial assets. According to their CEO, Arash, there has been no losing trades after just 5 days of launching. He has also made it very clear that their mission is to drive as much value into TAO as possible. Just think about the demand from financial institutions.
Wall Street, Main Street.
MyShell, a Tokyo-based decentralized AI platform, also recently launched Subnet 3 that focuses on the text-to-speech technology, which is an emerging AI tech that will have huge practical applications, including converting text to various forms of content like audiobooks and podcasts, etc. And MyShell is no joke. This is a platform where users can build, share, and possess their own AI agents. One such prominent use case is that of an AI companion, a chatbot where you can design to resemble specific characters, both real and imagined. Kind of like what you see in the movie, Her. They already have over 1 million users and 50,000 creators, and just raised $11 million from a mix of high-profile investors, including Dragonfly and former Coinbase CTO Balaji Srinivasan. MyShell is sharing their existing models and user base directly with Bittensor, enabling the network to vastly improve its machine learning models and user experience for millions of people.
This is great. This is the bee's knees, item 9.
There are also subnets dedicated to human language translation, audio, web scraping, and machine translation, to name a few. Today, there's a total of 32 subnets, but the network plans to double the number until it reaches 1,024 just this year alone. These subnets run on the purest form of free market capitalism, where only the most efficient, reliable, and valuable subnets survive and receive the most token emissions, while the subnets that lack use cases or users get less incentive or gets kicked out of the network. This puts pressure on the subnets to continuously innovate and to create truly useful AI products that can be enjoyed by the masses. What's crazy is that many of these subnets already have the same use cases as other top AI cryptocurrencies. For example, Fetch AI is a $3 billion market cap coin that allows you to use AI agents. Subnet 20's Bit Agent does the same thing. And what about the decentralized storage project Filecoin that commands a $4.5 billion market cap? Subnet 21, appropriately named File TAO, focuses on exactly that, storage. And what about the decentralized cloud computing network, Akash, that's worth $1 billion? As a matter of fact, Akash is joining forces with Subnet 27's Neural Internet. Every one of these subnets is its own potential billion-dollar entity. Once you venture down the Bittensor rabbit hole, you realize this network is the ultimate value aggregator for the entire AI crypto space. And the TAO token is the economic driver that unites them all. And hey, please give this video a thumbs up if you're enjoying our trip down the Bittensor rabbit hole.
This is so exciting.
So, how does it work? Within each subnet, there are miners and validators, all competing to create the best AI model. Miners, also called servers, are the ones running the actual machine learning models, while the validators are the ones who make sure the outputs from the miners are legit. Think of it like this. Imagine Bittensor as a town, and each subnet is a townsperson who has a particular skill set. Anytime you need something done, you go to the town square and ask. The validator collects your question, then passes it to the miners who will compete to propose their best answer. The answers are then passed to various validators who will rank them in order of quality. The best answer is then given to the user, and the ranking is recorded on the blockchain. This recorded interaction between the validators and the miners sit at the heart of Bittensor's innovation, and it's called the Yuma consensus. The miners who provided the best performing models receive the highest rewards of TAO tokens, while the validators are rewarded for accurate assessments of the miners. Charlie Munger once said, "Show me the incentive and I'll show you the outcome." Bittensor has created the best incentive-based competition mechanism for achieving the greatest machine intelligence. What's really cool is that all of these subnets communicate with each other. So whenever one model has a breakthrough, all the other models can immediately implement the learnings, which scales the intelligence exponentially. Also, anytime someone makes an AI model open sourced, Bittensor will be able to take that code base and level up all of its models. And with Elon Musk open sourcing his Grok AI, Bittensor will be a major beneficiary.
It's going to change the world.
So what about the genius creator behind Bittensor? The project was conceptualized and built by the Open Tensor Foundation, which was founded by two AI researchers, Jacob Steves and Ala Shabana. These are gigabrain AI scientists who aren't a couple of crypto bros trying to pump and dump. Steves worked at Google as a software engineer, and Shabana was an assistant professor at the University of Toronto with a PhD, who was also previously a senior software engineer at Instacart. They are Bitcoiners who have applied the best of what Bitcoin offers to Bittensor. Here's what Steves had to say.
The largest supercomputer in the world is Bitcoin, and it is that way because it's a permissionless system, one that any computer in the world can join. There is no bureaucracy. There's no one that you have to ask in order to enter that system. And you can get paid for the work that you do. So it's a very liquid, permissionless system. And that's what draws together all of this computation and allows to be used by that network. So we really just borrow that same technological foundation, that same structure of computation as the underpinning of our technology.
As a matter of fact, they drew so much inspiration from Bitcoin that they copied its supply dynamic. TAO, like BTC, has a total supply of 21 million tokens, and it follows a halving cycle every 4 years. And like Bitcoin, Bittensor had a fair launch and didn't have a pre-mine or an initial coin offering. Even the founders had to mine TAO from the very beginning.
Seems fair.
All the game theory dynamics at play for Bitcoin are also at play for Bittensor. The goal is to make the Bittensor network truly decentralized. So naturally, the mission at the Open Tensor Foundation is literally to wither away, thereby making TAO a legitimate digital commodity. This is much like how Satoshi Nakamoto disappeared from the world just 3 years after Bitcoin's inception. And today, BTC is the only true digital commodity in the eyes of regulators. Right now, the network subsidizes 7,200 TAO a day to give to the subnets as an inflationary reward for miners and validators. That number will get cut in half in August of 2025, and it will keep halving every 4 years until the total supply cap is reached. There are a ton of smart people getting behind Bittensor. It continues to be recognized or invested by the most prominent people in crypto. Ethereum's founder Vitalik Buterin has high praise for the project, who also dropped by the Bittensor Asia meetup and shared a panel with Jacob Steves, Digital Currency Group, one of the most influential companies in crypto, made his first investment in Bittensor in 2021. Foundry, the world's biggest Bitcoin mining pool, is one of the biggest Bittensor miners. They also run Subnet 28, which makes predictions on the S&P 500 price. Pantera Capital, arguably the leading crypto VC firm, also has a stake in TAO. Sami Kassab, who was previously a crypto analyst at Messari Research, which is arguably the world's leading crypto research platform, recently quit to become a partner at OSS Capital, where he'll be focusing entirely on investing and developing the Bittensor ecosystem. Even NVIDIA's current research manager and OpenAI's first intern, Jim Fang, looks to be convinced of Bittensor's value proposition, saying that maybe Web3 finally finds its truly useful application in AI.
Jim is great.
This sounds too good to be true, right? But like all investing, there still carries risks.
The project is still in its infancy, so there are still a lot of unknowns. Much of the network's UI is not very user-friendly yet. As with any crypto project, Bittensor may face regulatory challenges and uncertainties. And like any decentralized network, Bittensor may also be susceptible to security vulnerabilities. The developers could also poorly execute on the vision of the network.
Okay, all right, don't fuck this up.
So, when moon, you might ask? Here are some catalysts that I see sending the price of TAO to the moon. First off, Bittensor's first halving event is set to take place next year around September. If we look at Bitcoin's past three halving events, prices went parabolic. And if this is any indication, Bittensor's halving events will likely follow the same trajectory. You can trade TAO on top-tier exchanges like Binance and Bitget. But as of the time of recording, it still hasn't been listed on Coinbase, Bybit, and OKX, which could potentially be catalyst for major price action. On a longer term, as more businesses are built on the network that utilizes Bittensor's AI solutions, the demand for TAO naturally increases because users pay for services in this token. As more network effect is achieved and demand increases, but supply keeps getting cut in half every 4 years, you'll naturally see prices explode, just like Bitcoin. The rule of 80-20 also applies, where 20% of the top projects will suck in 80% of the value. Bittensor is a top three project in the AI crypto space, and it's poised to absorb the majority of the sector's value.
I'm placing my bets on the winners.
If Bitcoin is decentralized money, then Bittensor is decentralized intelligence. Bitcoin is currently sitting at a $1.3 trillion market cap. And if Bittensor can hit $1 trillion,
that will mean a 350x from its current market cap of around $2.8 billion.
Oh man, that would be insane.
Share this video with your friends so they'll thank you for bringing this opportunity to them. And if you like this video, you're definitely going to want to check out this video here.